Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to the Bowtie Breakdown. I'm Gary Morin, and today I'm going to explain some of the differences between a sewer system and a septic system. Now these two systems are extremely different and both offer some advantages and disadvantages. First, let's start with the sewer system. If you are purchasing a home that is connected to the sewers, that means your wastewater is transported to the treatment plant and not stored and treated on site at the property. In return, the homeowner will receive a quarterly sewer and water bill. There's nothing a homeowner needs to do with the wastewater except just flush the toilets. Simply flush the toilets, allow the waste to go down the drains and out to the plant. However, there are sometimes sewer assessments in place for the homeowner. This would happen if the sewers were recently installed in the area. Some of the advantages of being connected to the sewer include the burden of maintenance falling on the city or town, the homeowner not responsible for pumping anything, and tapping into the sewer system may only cost a couple of thousand dollars as opposed to tens of thousands for a new septic. Some disadvantages include the homeowner still being responsible for problems or issues on the house side of the pipes. It encourages an out of sight, out of mind behavior for the homeowner. They may not pay as much attention to the materials being thrown in the toilets or drains. There could be an outstanding sewer assessment being passed on to the buyer, so it's best to do some due diligence before you put in an offer on any property. Now, let's talk about the advantages and disadvantages of the septic system. There's a septic tank and a leach field that contain the waste. The waste is sent into the system and the solids are filtered and the rest of the waste is stored and treated right there on site on the property. Some advantages you can expect with the septic system are number one, no sewer bill. There's no tax assessment because the homeowner is responsible for the waste removal. And finally, you can use septics where sewers do not exist. Some disadvantages of a septic system include the homeowner being responsible to maintain and pump the system. The homeowner must pay attention to what is being thrown in the toilets and drains, and large rainstorms could potentially cause flooding. They could be really expensive to replace or install. So there you have it. That was some of the advantages and disadvantages of sewers and septic systems. Both are really great systems and serve a purpose for the home, so it's really a matter of preference and function for the homeowner. That was another Bowtie Breakdown. I'm Gary Morin, the Bowtie Guy. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week.